in Floresta, Colorado, just up the mountain from the small little town of Crested Butte. We've actually put a building up here before a few years back. We'll put a link to that in this series, just so you can see that other building. There's not much there. It's really just a time lapse. But since we're up here and we're working for friends, we thought that we'd bring a small crew with us, help them put it up, and do a video series on this. We've tried to do this in the past, but really we're never able to get around to going over each and every detail. So today we're gonna start filming, and this is all gonna be instructional. It's all gonna be how-to, and we're gonna get a lot of tips and tricks in. A lot of string line work, a lot of just making things really, really tight. I got one of our new employees here, Aaron. He's probably a 15, 20 year veteran of erecting pre-engineered metal buildings. And he came on a few months ago with us really to assist me in answering day-to-day questions on, helping customers. You know, with the volume that we're doing, we get so many calls. I'm unable to actually do most of those calls myself. So he's been a great help. And so what we have here is, we're about probably 10,500 feet. We have a 36-foot long, 92-foot wide, so a 92 by 36. I think the eaves is just a 1-on-12 slope. This building has a 250-pound snow load, so there's going to be columns and rafters and purlins all over this thing just to support that snow load. Hopefully you guys can hear me all right because the lift is working over there. We got the semi-truck with the building actually coming in here right now. So we're gonna be drilling and epoxying. We got 1, 2, 2, 4, 6, 8 sets of bolts that we're gonna drill and epoxy. So we're gonna show you how we lay that out. And when we cut this up or edit this, we're gonna be referring to this set of plans a lot. So the topics that I intend to cover, just so you guys know, and hopefully in the description of this video, we'll have a link to the other video, like specifically what we're doing, you know, what video to go and check out, so that you can easily go to, you know, any of the information you need. We're gonna go over the steel line information, how we're starting panels, how we're finishing panels, how we're cutting panels, how we're trimming out the framed openings. The bolts here are almost perfect, but hopefully we run into a couple of minor issues that we can go over, things that, you know, you might expect to see in the field. So a little bit about this building. This one's kind of unique. So besides the snow load and the location, the panels on this, through a new supplier that we have, we're actually able to get cold rolled panels. So these are what are used in what we call like a Telluride roof, rusted panels that rust out, look vintage. These are 24 gauge panels, but what we did, instead of doing the standard corrugated panel that you usually see with that stuff, we ran it through the roll former and ran it in our profile. And then we did cocoa brown trim to match. And all the screws are cocoa brown, so they'll match it when it rusts out. And it'll be pretty cool. It's gonna be a real fun project, and hopefully, not even just for Great Western buildings, but hopefully for anybody, this, I intend for this to be, you know, one of the more useful videos for instructions on how to, or at least series. So here comes the truck. You might want to check that out. But anyways, I'll see you here on the next video, and we'll start getting to this. Thanks.